Hi dear students, welcome to Indian Brain YouTube channel. This is Narsingh. Today onwards we are going to discuss all the problems in English version because so many students are requesting me to do videos in English. That's why I have started an English version. So anyway, today in this session we are going to discuss profit and loss topic. So actually, what do you mean by profit and what do you mean by loss? Where we can use these words actually, profit and loss. So logically in business, right? Business is nothing but what? Purchasing and selling, right? If I take a simple example here, I bought an article for 1000 rupees and sold it for 1300. Is it profit or loss? So logically profit, right? How much profit I am getting here? 300 rupees profit is there. But how to convert into percentage, that is very important. Because here always we need to consider it in the original investment what we have invested here. 1000 rupees is the investment, right? Yes or no? Here 1300 can be taken as selling price. Investment is 1000 rupees, 1300 can be the selling price. What is the exact profit we are getting here? 300 rupees, right? But how to convert into percentage is the matter here. So the entire profit and loss topic is nothing but how to convert into percentages. It may be profit or loss. Is it clear? Okay, how to convert into percentage here? 300 rupees profit on what? The original investment was 1000, right? This 1000 can be called as cost price. This 1300 can be called as selling price. Okay, this can be taken as profit, but how to convert into percentage? So this 300 should be compared on 1000 rupees into 100. This is the profit percentage value we have, right? So but how to get the loss here? Loss means always the selling price should be less than cost price. For an example, I bought an article for 800 rupees and sold it for 600 rupees. Logically loss, right? How much loss is there here? 200 rupees loss. But how to convert this 200 rupees into percentage? That's very important, right? So 200 rupees loss on what? Always we need to concentrate on, it may be profit or loss, always we need to concentrate on what? The original investment. Yeah, here the original investment is what? 800 only. That's why 200 should be compared on 800 into 100. That can be your answer. So whatever the answer, I don't want to answer. The concept is important. Okay, always remember one thing, always the profit value should be compared on investment. It may be profit or loss, that should be compared on investment. That's it. So okay, fine, this is what original procedure we have, but how to get the answer in easy way without formulas? Of course this topic will have 32 to 35 formulas, so but it is very difficult to remember those all formulas, right? So that's why we need to avoid all the formulas without single formula. How to crack every question with your intelligence based on universal facts? That's my intention. Okay, before going to that particular topic, first of all we need to concentrate on the original investment. Whatever the investment is there here, whatever the investment is there, this can be taken as what? 100% value. Is it clear? Whatever the investment is there, it can be taken as 100%. It may be 1000, 2000, 5000, whatever, whatever. Okay, if I convert this particular percentage value, what will be the answer here? Logically answer will be 30%, right? Yes, this 30% can be taken as what? Profit percentage. Investment can be 100%, 30% can be the profit percentage, but how to decide the selling price here? This can be taken as 130%, right? Yes, keep in mind, if I get 30% profit, selling price will be 130%. If I get 40% profit, selling price can be 140%. If I get 20% loss, selling price should be less than 100. That's it, 80%. Is it clear? If I get profit, it should be above 100. If I get loss, it should be below 100. That's it. But originally, always the investment can be taken as 100%. This is a basic concept. It's very interesting concept to calculate profit and loss without formula. Okay? Let's start with the questions from R.S. Agarwal, old version book. So very first question is what? I gain 70 paisa on 70. My gain percentage is what? I gain 70 paisa on 70 rupees. So I got 70 paisa. 70 paisa should be compared on what? 70 rupees. Yes or no? But how to convert into percentage? If I have paisa, it is not suitable for calculation part, right? That's why the 70 paisa should be converted into rupees. If I have 70 paisa, logically 0.7 rupees will be there, right? If I have 20 paisa, 0.2 rupees will be there. If I have 50 paisa, 0.5 rupees will be there. The same way, if I have 70 paisa, it can be 0.7 rupees. This 0.7 rupees should be compared on what? 70 rupees into 100 can be your answer, right? So as we know, what is 10% worth of 70? It will be 7. What is 10% worth of 70 will be? 10% worth of 7 will be 7. So 1% of worth will be what? 0.7, right? So logically answer can be what here? 1% profit. Is it clear? So once again, 70%, 10% value 7. 100% value 0.7. Yes, we have 0.7 here. That's why answer 1% will be there. Very easy. Or else if you go for the calculation, 0 point will be get cancelled. 0, 0 get cancelled. 7 by 7 answer can be 1, right? It's very easy to calculate. Okay, fine. So this is what, how to calculate profit percentage for the first question. So in the second question, it is saying that in terms of percentage profit, which is the best transaction? He has given the cost prices and as well as profit values. So according to cost prices and profit values, we need to decide the maximum percentage value. Because in terms of percentage profit, which is the best transaction? What is the word itself is showing? The best transaction means what? The maximum value we need to calculate. That's why just avoid this total second question. Because here we below only one way. That's it. This is 36. I'm getting profit as 17. Logically, this 17 should be compared on what? 36 into 100 can be what? Our gain percentage. So in the same way, we need to calculate all the values. Then we can get the clarity for the exact maximum value. Okay. That's why I need not to discuss this second question because it is calculation part. It is not concept oriented. Is it clear? So let's go for the third question. Book. So bought at a price ranging from 200 to 350 are sold at a price ranging from 300 to 425. What is the greatest possible profit that might be made in selling 8 books? So actually here the cost price of a particular book value is what? 200 to 350. This is the what? The range of cost price of a particular book. Okay. So the selling prices are nothing but here the range of the selling price is what? 300 to 425. Okay. The minimum value of cost price is about 200, the maximum cost price will be 350. The minimum selling price should be 300, the maximum selling price should be 425, right? So here, I need to get more profit. When I can get more profit, that's very important point. Very silly question actually. Here, 200 rupees is the minimum investment. If I have low investment and high selling price, then I can get more profit value, right? That is a basic thought we have. So that's why I need to choose the lowest cost price. Where is the lowest cost price? We have 200 is the lowest cost price. I need to select highest selling price. In these two, which one is the highest? 425. So logically my low investment will be 200, high selling price will be 425, then I can get more profit. This is a basic knowledge we have, yes or no? So how much profit I am get for every article, because it is for each article or each book value. So that's why if a cost price is 200, selling price is 425, on every book I can get 225 rupees as a profit. But I need to purchase total 8 books, not one book, right? So that's why 8 books into 225 rupees can be our direct profit value. He's asking maximum profit worth for 8 books. So that's why 8 into 225. Let's go for 8, 200 is 1600. 825 is a 200. 600 plus 200 will be, so 1800 can be our answer. That's it. Very simple, right? Okay, this is what? Question number 3. So let's go for question number 4. A shopkeeper sold an article for 2090, not sold, but it is, bought. A shopkeeper bought an article for 2090.42. Approximately what will be the percentage of profit if he sold that article for 260.58? Yeah, he is purchasing the particular article for very easy 2090.42. Okay, so next one is what will be the profit percentage if the article is sold for 260. This is what investment is, it is selling it for what? 260.58. 58. So this is what cost price, this is what selling price, right? So how to get the profit percentage here? But the question itself saying is what? I need to get approximate value, not exact value. So if it is exact value, it will be difficult to calculate. But whenever we have approximate questions, then it is very easy to solve. Yeah, let's go for the calculation now. 2090 is there, 2602 is there. I can take it as what? Approximately 2000. Okay, I can take it as what? Approximately 2000. So this can be taken as what? 2600, right? Approximately 2600. Actually, it will be 2100 because 2090 is very near to 2100, right? So if you are going to go for 2100 also, no problem with that. This is 2100, this is 2600. So logically, 500 rupees is the profit, right? That 500 should be converted into percentage. That's it. 500 rupees profit on what? 2100. So 500 should be compared on 2100 into 100 can be our answer, right? So if it is 2000, what will be the answer here? If it is 2000, what will be the answer? 00 is get canceled. 00 get canceled. The answer will be 25%, right? It may be 2100. It may be 2000. The approximate answer can be what here? 25. So answer will be 25%. Very easy to calculate because it is approximate. Happily, we can make it as round figure. Then we can get the answer in easy way, right? So good. So let's go for the next question.